So it's decided, my new build is going to be called Bane, and this is build log part number one. Enjoy. How's it going, guys and girls? My name is Episode 7, and I think this is another vlog. I'm not too sure what I'm going to call this, but I thought I'd update you guys on what's going on in my life and what I'm working on at the moment. Sorry for the light, but due to the fact that my down lights are turning off in my room, I need to wear a light so that people don't complain about the lighting in my videos. But yeah, enough of me talking. I'm going to go ahead and show you guys what I've been up to. So, oh, that's actually working all right, eh? So here's my rig right now. Yeah, everything's so messy in this room at the moment, all because of this rig. I don't know if you guys know what exactly happened to me, but I water cooled my graphics cards and that caused my power supply to play up, so I had to get a new power supply. It wasn't because of the water cooling all the graphics cards, it was the faulty power supply. There's a lot of people that are having problems with the Corsair HX1050s, so yeah, I had to return that. It did melt. My extenders. I don't know if you guys can notice, but the threading is coming off of my extender because inside it is melting, and I had to put some alifoil inside one of the pins so that it can like remain contact, because inside the actual wire it's melted, because I don't know if it was my fault for not connecting the 8 pin on my motherboard, like the extra 8 pin that I have there. I don't know if it was my fault. You can see there's the 8 pin right there. Yeah, right there. That's my sound card, by the way. So, oh my god, this light thing is so weird. That's better. That's my sound card right there. And yeah, I don't know if it was my fault for not connecting the 8 pin, or if it was the power supply's fault, but I'm pretty sure it was the power supply's fault due to the fact that I only had two cards in here. I had two EVGA GTX 580s, and that shouldn't be that demanding where I need to connect an 8 pin. So yeah, the power supply sort of effed up my motherboard, but I've got that sorted. I fixed that, and I pulled out the cards because I didn't want to water cool my cards anymore because I got pissed off with the power supply. I got a new power supply. I got a 1000 V1000 from Cooler Master to match the case. So yeah, I've got thread cables. I've still got my RAM. I've still got my my CPU. So yeah, you guys are probably wondering, oh well, it's a faulty power supply. What's the big deal? But after the power supply gave up, well, it didn't exactly give up. After the power supply decided to have a go at my rig, my CPU block failed on me for some reason. So I had a really bad, like bad 3 years of trying to water cool this thing, just getting bad faulty parts for some reason. I don't know if the companies are cheaping out on parts or if it's just me, but yeah, this CPU block gave up on me. Like, you can't even, it doesn't even let a tiny bit of water pass through it. Like, I will try to breathe through it. Far out, they're still cooling in there. I don't know if you guys heard that, but it's having so much trouble passing water through it. And I know I could just clean it. I tried cleaning it. I put it in vinegar. I got told to put it in vinegar. That did stuff it up completely. But yeah, I did get told to pull it apart and clean it with a toothbrush and stuff like that. But I thought, you know, it's dying. I'm not gonna try and fight with it. I'm just gonna pass it on. And at first I thought it was my pump that stuffed up, because the water wasn't flowing correctly. So I went and got a new pump, but it wasn't the pump that stuffed up. So my bad, I guess. Look, that's the thing with water cooling. That's why I don't know if I can recommend water cooling to everybody on my channel and my page on Facebook. I do have Facebook. I'll leave the link down below. That's why I can't recommend water cooling. I don't know if I can't recommend it. I do recommend it to some extent, but like, it's just so finicky, man. If you don't know what you're doing, you're going to get hurt. And I've done a lot of research, and I did put a lot of hours into this rig and trying to find out what goes where. And for the most part, it worked out for me. But then again, it didn't, because the rig is still incomplete, and it's been like 3 years since I started water cooling this thing. So yeah, this is my hand was in the wrong. My fans are the same. My radiator is the same. I'm going to put new tubing because my tubing stuffed up. Here's my pump. Here's my pump. I bought a new one. I bought an EK one. Because yeah, as I said before, I thought it was my pump because the water wasn't flowing very well, but it ended up being this bitch right here. Sorry for the language. I did manage to buy a new CPU block. This one hopefully will go a lot better. This is the Raystorm one and it does have LEDs, but I don't know where the hell the LEDs have gone. So basically you put LEDs in the side and it lights up the acrylic around the black frame. So yeah, I do have a video on that, so check my page if you want to see that. Yeah, I did sort of do an overview of that, and yeah, it's going to go in my rig real soon. There's just the bowl for draining my rig. There's my reservoir that isn't changing, the old tubing with the fittings. Thing I noticed about these fittings, I don't know if you guys can tell very well in the video, but the paint is scraping off. I don't know why that is. I was very careful when I was undoing these fittings, and I was very careful when I was putting it in my rig. I didn't do anything wrong. So I don't know if it's just over time, or I don't know if it's the coolant that got to the paint, or I don't know if it's when I was undoing and redoing the actual fittings that my skin rubbed on the fitting, or rubbed the paint off the fitting. I don't know if it's, did that make sense? Yeah, I don't know if my skin rubbed on the fitting or if it's the paint, but I'm pretty sure it's the paint. So maybe it was my skin, maybe my skin rubbed off the paint. The paint's not that high standard, but I really do wish they put proper paint on these things, but I guess that's what happens when you paint metal. It's bound to scrape off sooner or later. There's my old pump. It's still going well. I don't know what I'm going to do with it. I don't know if I'm going to put this old pump back in my rig or the new one. I might return the new one if they do let me do that, but it's been like 4 months, so I don't think they will. So I might just end up using the new pump and just having this on reserve just in case something fails. Yeah, that is a part of my Bit Phoenix. I'm such a loser. That is a part of the pump mod kit. I do a video on this as well if you guys want to check that out. So yeah, it is part of my pump mod kit. So basically the pump looked like this, and as you can see, that's pretty ugly. So I did get a pump mod kit for it, and yeah, I don't know what else to say. I've gone through everything. There's my reservoir. That's how I thought my pump failed, because the spindle, because the flow meter wasn't spinning very well. This does have a lot of algae in it. As you can see, it's got like a lot of fog and shit. I don't know how the hell that got there, but I'm going to have to try and clean that, make it clear again. I don't know how I'm going to clean it, so if you guys have any ideas, let me know. So yeah, that's basically it. That's all I have planned for this rig. All right, before I do end this this vlog sort of overview, sort of review, sort of unboxing, I'm going to go ahead and show you guys what I bought for the rig. I did tell you that I got rid of my water cooling graphics cards because I didn't want to water cool anymore, so I decided to get these. These were really cheap on Amazon. So I picked up two of them. So they're the GTX 780 Ti's, the MSI ones. Apparently these ones are really good. I'm going to open the box for you guys right here. I'm going to open it right here, so we have all the accessories and whatnot. And then we have the card itself. So I've got to make sure I take that plastic off. I'm pretty sure there's plastic on there. So here's the card. As you can see, it's a really nice looking card. Really nice and clean. I really wish the back had a back cover, a back plate for the PCB. But I guess that's why the card was so cheap, probably. I don't mind. I actually like that it's a black PCB. It's not a blue one. It suits my rig. And I guess, you know, the backplate doesn't really make a difference. It does make the rig look a lot cleaner. I don't really mind having the PCB visible so that, you know, you can see what's going on with the card. You don't even know. They might give you a card with a backplate and you don't even know if there's a GPU on board. Nah, that's just a geek joke. But yeah, so that's my graphics card right there. I've got two of them. They are going in my rig real soon. I will have videos on the build. I will make sure that I document it and put them up on the channel. So yeah, guys, thanks for sticking with me. Thanks for subscribing. And I hope you guys see this video real soon. Don't forget to subscribe, like, rate, favorite, and do all that stuff. And I'll catch you on the next one. I look like the miners from that cartoon movie. All right, guys. See ya. Take care.